Hi everybody, my name is Mary Lee and I work at Granite and Marble Works in upstate New York. Today we're going to be talking about staining and etching in the kitchen. Marble kitchen countertops have been increasing in popularity over the past year, and we've been getting a lot of questions about the maintenance requirements, whether or not it's the right material for a particular customer, as well as what are some good alternatives to marble if you want the marble look, but not the marble upkeep. So in front of me today, I have five different materials. I have a manufactured stone called Viatera Rococo. I also have Carrara marble, which is the classic marble look. I have two quartzites, and quartzites vary a lot in terms of softness and hardness. Some quartzites have marble-like characteristics, and the one I have here is called Dolce Vita, and that does have some marble characteristics, so a little calcium carbonate in there, as well as an incredibly hard stone called Sea Pearl. And finally, I have a nice granite called Colonial White. You'll also notice that I have two of each sample. So one of the ways we combat staining in the kitchen is by applying a permanent sealer to all of our natural stone. And what this sealer does, it seeps into all the unseen holes in the material and protects it from a nice glass of red wine spilling onto your countertop and getting into those holes. Now, all natural stone has these unseen holes in it, and that's why we put a permanent sealer on. However, marble is a lot more porous than something like granite or quartzite. So having this in the kitchen opens you up to more possibility to stain even with a permanent sealer on the material. That being said, I think it'll be a lot more fun for me and a lot more informative for you to see what happens when we put some red wine, some tomato sauce, a little bit of lemon juice and olive oil on all these samples, let them sit overnight, and then wipe it all off. We're also going to be able to see what the sealer actually is preventing against and how good of a job it does. So without further ado, I'm going to make a mess. All right, we're gonna let these sit overnight, clean them up tomorrow, and see what happens. All right, guys, so this is day two of the experiment. Our samples have been sitting for about 18 hours. I'm gonna clean them off and we're gonna see what the results look like. Okay, so our samples are all cleaned off, and we can really see what these sorts of things in the kitchen do to each individual material. I wasn't expecting the granite to stain as much as it did, but I think it's a really good example of how a sealer will protect from staining. If you look at the unsealed granite, you can see how deep the wine got in there. But when you look at the unsealed sample, there is a little bit of spotting, but it's not too bad. Otherwise, the tomato sauce didn't have an effect on it, neither did the oil or the lemon juice. Our Sea Pearl quartzite was completely impenetrable, which is really amazing. I was expecting something, but nothing got through on the sealed or the unsealed sample. The Dolce Vita, on the other hand, that has more of those marble-like characteristics, was definitely affected by just about everything we put on. If you look closely, you can see in both the sealed sample as well as the unsealed sample, there's a lot of etching. So a lot of lighter spots where the lemon was, you can see that the polish has come off where the wine and the tomato sauce were put. The oil didn't really have an effect on it, but this was certainly affected by the acidity of those kitchen items. The marble as well, you can see the lemon looks like a burn on this sample here. And as I move the camera over each sample, you can see pretty clearly how the polish has been removed, but there's no staining, which is kind of cool. If you look at the quartz, nothing really happened to the quartz, and the reason for that is there's not a lot of room, or there's actually zero room for things like wine or anything that you would use in the kitchen to seep in. Quartz is made up of crushed quartz and epoxies, so there aren't the same issues with porosity. I guess the takeaway for me would be that you should really ask a lot of questions about how you interact with your kitchen, as well as about the material that you're interested in buying. So if you, again, if you are looking for that marble look without the possibility to etch, it seems like the sea pearl is a really good option. Granted, this experiment is very extreme. I don't think anybody leaves this amount of lemon juice or wine or tomato sauce on their countertops for 18 hours straight. But I think it's a good point of reference for you moving forward. Thanks for watching.